at the day of the resurrection against the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is saying, is going to say, وقال الرسول يا رب إن قومي اتخذوا هذا القرآن مهجورا. Oh Allah, my people have shunned off this Quran. They left this Quran. They are not attached to this Quran. And believe me, brothers and sisters, if you are attached to this Quran, you are attached to Allah جل وعلا. You are attached, the most powerful one in the whole world. And you will enjoy this life because you feel that you are very close to the Creator of the whole world. Believe me, brothers and sisters, if you are attached to the Quran, your life will be different. You will be a different person. You will not feel frustrated. You will not feel bored in this life. You will have meaning for this life. And that's why we need to continue our attachment to the Book of Allah جل وعلا. Make sure from now, as a commitment, a promise that you have to fulfill, that you don't miss recitation of the Quran every single day. Keep a copy of the Quran with you. And that copy, if you don't read Arabic, or if you don't understand Arabic, the copy that has Arabic and English, and read the Arabic and read the English translation and try to match between the Arabic and the English in order for you to understand what you read, in order for you to learn Arabic. And make a commitment that next month of Ramadan, your understanding of the Quran, your ability to recite the Quran should be better. Shame on every single Muslim who has been Muslim for a number of years and yet he is unable to recite the Quran fluently. Shame on him, shame on her, shame on us as the Ummah of the Quran, and we do these mistakes on this book, the Book of Life. Brothers and sisters, it is also good to remind ourselves that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam obliged upon us zakat al-fitr, and all of us know hadith Ibn Abbas, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah made zakat al-fitr obligation as a purification for the fasting person from indecent acts. طهرةً للصائم من اللغو والرفث وطعمةً للمساكين, and food for the devastated or the poor people. And Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam obliged zakat al-fitr sa' from food on the male, on the female, on the slave, on the free person, on the young, on the old. All, every single Muslim should give zakat al-fitr, which is the amount of one sa' or the value to buy the sa' of food. Sa' of food is almost 2.5 kilograms of food. Every single Muslim should pay that. And it should be given before Salatul Eid. So you can't give it now. Go be hasty and give it now. So many people say that we missed it and Salatul Eid was established and we could not give it. So do it now. And the father or the household, the head of the household members, he should give it for the members. And according to the other opinion, every single member of the household, it's better for him or her to give it by him or herself. If a lady is the head of that household member, she should give him on their behalf as well, even if she is a female. This is zakat al-fitr. And also, brothers and sisters, it is good to remind ourselves that the Eid, once the Eid is announced, then it is the sunnah to make takbir from the time the Eid is announced. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, and to complete the count of the month and to glorify Allah Jalla wa Ala for the guidance that Allah Jalla wa Ala has given to you. What is the meaning of the Eid, brothers and sisters? The meaning of the Eid is that you feel happy that you have completed the month of Ramadan. Many of us don't understand the meaning of the Eid, and they think they compare the Eid with Christmas. No, it is different. Our Eids are different, have meanings. Our Eids that we feel happy that we have completed a ibadah. That's why the Eid of Al-Adha after the completion of Arafah. The Eid of Al-Fitr is after the completion of the fasting of the Ramadan. We feel happy that Allah Jalla wa Ala gave us this opportunity. And the sunnah is to make the takbir. Once the Eid is announced, to make the takbir. And as the Sahaba used to do more takbir in Eid al-Fitr than Eid al-Adha. And this is the one among the sunnah that have been left out. It is also sunnah during the Eid is to take bath before going to the Eid. It is sunnah to have some few dates, witr number of dates, before going to the Eid. And in particular, once you are going to the Eid, if you can, it is good, it is sunnah to make a lot of takbir. It is also sunnah, as it is mentioned in Hadith Umar, that to wear the best of your clothes. Also, it is sunnah to take your household members, even women and men, if there is a place that they can attend next to the masjid. Even the young ladies, they should go to see, to witness, as Hadith Ibn Atiyah, to witness the khayr and the da'wah of the Muslims, means the gathering of Muslims, and the khayr that Allah Jalla wa Ala sent down when this gathering is taking place. These are sunnah. And we have to be careful when we take our families, they should observe hijab and modest clothes. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to accept our deeds, and we ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to forgive our shortcomings. اللهم يا حي يا قيوم يا بديع السماوات والأرض اللهم يا بديع السماوات والأرض إنا نسألك أن تجعلنا في هذا الشهر الكريم من عتقائك من النار اللهم اجعلنا من عتقائك من النار اللهم اجعلنا من عتقائك من النار اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والغنيمة من كل بر اللهم إنا نسألك الغنيمة من كل بر اللهم إنا نسألك الغنيمة من كل بر اللهم إنا نسألك السلامة من كل إثم اللهم إنا نسألك الفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكيها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم ارض عن الخلفاء الأربع أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعلى من تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وقوم إلى صلاتكم
Please move forward. الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا